सर, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। आई वेलकम टू टुडेज वेबिनार। आई प्रोफेसर वसंत पवार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एट डॉक्टर अंबेडकर कॉलेज इज द कन्वेनर ऑफ द वेबिनार। थैंक यू फॉर टेकिंग अ टाइम आउट एंड बीइंग हियर टुडे। इनिशियली आई सैल्यूट टू परम पूज्य भारत रत्न डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर, दी आर्किटेक्ट ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस, एंड प्रे टू द लॉर्ड गौतम बुद्ध। दी चीफ गेस्ट ऑफ द वेबिनार्स आर ऑनरेबल भंते आर्य नागार्जुन सुरेश ससाई, इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ परम पूज्य डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर स्मारक समिति, होली दीक्षा भूमि नागपुर। ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर मुरलीधर चांदेकर इज द वाइस चांसलर ऑफ आरटीएम नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी, एंड रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर नीरज खटी सर इज द रजिस्ट्रार ऑफ आरटीएम नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी, रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर सुधीर फुलझेले सर इज द सेक्रेटरी एंड द डायरेक्टर ऑफ डॉक्टर आंबेडकर स्मारक समिति, होली दीक्षा भूमि। द चेयरपर्सन ऑफ ए नेशनल वेबिनार इज डॉक्टर प्रतिभा सीरिया मैडम, इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ए डॉक्टर अंबेडकर कॉलेज, एंड द स्पीकर ऑफ द वेबिनार्स आर डॉक्टर अभय देशपांडे, इज द डायरेक्टर ऑफ एस एस जी एम्बेडेड सोल्यूशंस, एंड डॉक्टर नीलेश मेश्राम इज द एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फ्रॉम ए मथुरा दास मोहता साइंस कॉलेज नागपुर। दी को कन्वेनर ऑफ द वेबिनार इज डॉक्टर सतीश जय शर्मा, इज द हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कंप्यूटर साइंस फ्रॉम आरटीएम नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी। डॉक्टर प्रदीप दहीकर इज द चेयरमैन ऑफ ए बोर्ड ऑफ स्टडीज इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स आरटीएम नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी नागपुर। डॉक्टर हेमा मेनन इज ए आईक्यूएसी कोऑर्डिनेटर। दिवाकर द्विवेदी इज द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द वेबिनार्स। डॉक्टर एन वी शिवरकर, मिसेस पूनम यादव आर द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग मेंबर्स, एंड ऑल फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, स्टूडेंट्स एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स फ्रॉम द वेरियस कॉलेज, आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन दिस वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर ए ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग नेशनल वेबिनार ऑन ए रोल ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर इन ए डे टू डे लाइफ कंडक्टेड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉलेज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स डॉक्टर अम्बेडकर कॉलेज इन एसोसिएशन विद द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कंप्यूटर साइंस आरटीएम नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी। थैंक यू वेरी मच। आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर अंबेडकर कॉलेज डॉक्टर पी एम सीरिया मैडम टू प्लीज डिलीवर द वेलकम एड्रेस। प्लीज टू डिलीवर वेलकम एड्रेस।
थैंक यू पवार सर। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। टुडे I feel very happy to welcome you all to this national webinar, and it's my proud privilege to brief you all about my institution. Dr. Ambedkar College, Nagpur, founded by the visionary late Padma Shri Dada Saheb Gaikwad in 1964, and is affiliated to Rashtra Sant Tukdoji Maharaj Nagpur University, Nagpur, is indeed a time-tested center for higher learning. Ladies and gentlemen, we are all aware that Dr. Ambedkar College runs under the aegis of Paramapujya Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Smarak Samiti, is situated in the sprawling premises of the Holi Diksha Bhumi, which is the historic place where Bharat Ratna Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar embraced Buddhism. With a modest beginning in 1964, the institution now has 56 glorious years of experience in imparting quality education in the faculties of arts, commerce, science, law, and management. With its uncompromising standards of excellence, our institution believes in imparting man-making, character building, and value-added education. The reaccreditation of the college as A-grade by NAC and the status of college with potential for excellence conferred by the UGC bears eloquent testimony of its unshifting commitment to quality. Dr. Ambedkar College is truly a college like none other, and it is not surprising that it has won a very special and unique place in the academic, extracurricular, and sports landscape of Nagpur city, Vidarbha region, as well as in the central India. The strength of college students is approximately 5,000 students, a very big institution. Ladies and gentlemen, we have assembled here for the one-day national webinar on role of microcontroller in electronic day-to-day life, which is organized by the Department of Electronics of a college in association with Department of Electronics and Computer Science, RTM Nagpur University, Nagpur. I, Dr. Mrs. Pratibha M. Siria, principal of the college, welcome all the delegates, participants, and research scholars for this national webinar. I would like to extend my warm welcome to all the eminent speakers of this webinar, Dr. S.J. Sharma, Dr. Abhay Deshpande, and Dr. Nilesh Mishra. I am sure that today's webinar would be very informative and beneficial to all the participants. I appreciate the efforts taken by our faculty members, Sri V.S. Pawar, HOD Electronics, Dr. N.V. Shivarkar, and Dr. H.J. Sharma, HOD Electronics and Computer Science, RTM Nagpur University, and Mr. D.V. Dwivedi for organizing today's national webinar. Once again, on behalf of Dr. Ambedkar College, Dikshabhumi, Nagpur, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, madam. Now, I would like to invite Dr. S.J. Sharma to deliver his inaugural address. Please.
Thank you, Vasant Pawar. Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Sharma from Department of Electronics and Computer Science. It is indeed a pleasure for me to have an association with the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar College, Nagpur, to start one-day seminar on role of microcontrollers in day-to-day life. Everyone is basically worried, the students recently are worried about what will happen to them after COVID-19 situation unlocks. The first question is, how do they start their career? Because the final year students, they have to make a career after the when they pass out. And what is the role of the microcontrollers or embedded systems in their life? Will they be able to start their own enterprise in case they choose a microcontrollers or embedded systems? So I think this topic is very relevant. And we know that since March, when the lockdown was announced, the whole environment in India or abroad is completely flooded with the webinars, seminars, hands-on training. But this one is entirely different because we have a person from the industry who has given consultancy to more than 250 companies and who is a person very innovative and had designed a lot of products. Dr. A.P. Deshpande is the right kind of person in embedded systems or microcontrollers. So he will be basically of an immense help for the present generation in order to cope up the pressure, how to choose a career. You find that the embedded systems, they find a lot of applications in our household activities, in the home automation, in washing machines, in digital camera, even in mobiles, even biomedical instruments, in industries. In fact, Industry 4.0 is the latest trend, and it has found a lot of applications in industry, especially in IoT-based systems or wireless sensor networks. It finds a lot of applications, process control, or even packaging, delivering, robotics is another application. So you find that this particular topic, which is the role of microcontrollers in day-to-day life, probably it has become the lifestyle. Microcontroller has become a lifestyle. And classic example is Dr. A.P. Deshpande, who has imbibed microcontroller as his lifestyle. So with these words, I really welcome all the keen learners and listeners to the one-day seminar on role of microcontrollers in day-to-day life. Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to be associated with a very prestigious college. And our department, as you know, it started way back in 1987 in the university with only a few students in the course, that is MSc Electronics. The department started in the corridors of Department of Physics. And now you find the department has an independent building. And then there is a computer section, that is MSc Computer Science, was introduced in the university in 2015 and 16. Now we have MSc Electronics and MSc Computer Science as the two courses running independently in the two buildings. And you will find that the department has been able to really mobilize the grant to the tune of more than 1.3 crores. We have an independent biomedical instrumentation laboratory, which will be useful to the students of the undergraduates and the postgraduates. We are also planning to start the diploma course in the biomedical instrumentation. I think this particular field, by which is now coming up in a big way, and Honorable Prime Minister has also given a clarion call to the youngsters, the young generations of India, that one should go for the indigenous systems, make in India, make in Maharashtra, and make in Nagpur. You will be happy to note that the Department of Electronics and Computer Science, the research scholars have designed their own research grade instruments. To almost like 15 instruments have been designed indigenously inside the laboratory of Department of Electronics and Computer Science. And I think that is a big achievement. And the students recently, they are really keen on learning new things, practicing them, and trying to think some innovative ideas. So with this particular trend that is going on, we are keeping pace with the technology, and the students will certainly be benefited with this particular one-day webinar. Thank you. Thank you, Vasant Pawar. And over to the organizers for the next deliberations.
Thank you very much, sir. Now, in this webinar, we are going to discuss the need of microcontroller in our day-to-day life. For that, firstly, we need to understand a difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. Microprocessor is at a central processing unit, and it is used in general purpose, which is contains no RAM, no ROM, no input-output ports on a chip. They are able to handle the load of a data, whereas microcontroller has a central processing unit. In addition to RAM, ROM, input-output ports, and timers, all embedded on a single chip. Though microprocessor is a heart of the computer, and microcontroller is a brain of the computer system. In many applications, microprocessors needs more space, consumes more powers, and it is expensive, whereas microcontroller takes less space, less power, and it is cheaper in nature. Microcontroller has many applications, widely applications in the field of all. In the field of, for example, home appliances, like intercom, telephone, security system, fax machine, computer, remote controls. Hence, there are so many applications of the microcontroller. Hence, it is a necessity to learn a microcontroller. Now, the speaker of... Now, I hereby take a pleasure for introducing the guest speaker of this session is Dr. Nilesh Meshram, who is the associate professor and head department of electronics working at Mathura Das Mohta Science College, Nagpur. He did his postgraduate degree in the age of 22 years in electronics from an biomedical instrumentations and interfacing. He awarded PhD.
Good morning, one and all. First of all, I would like to place my thanks for the nice introduction by Dr. Pawar sir, Professor Pawar sir, and I thanks to all the organizing committee for giving me this opportunity to present this talk. So I will start with my talk. The topic is role of microcontrollers in day-to-day life. So we are right now working on the pandemic of COVID-19. So the topic which is very much related to this webinar is like applications of microcontrollers in the field of biomedical instrumentation. So I would like to emphasis on this, application of microcontrollers in biomedical instrumentation itself. The topics that is I'm likely to cover in this presentation are the background information of microcontrollers, introduction, applications, sensors and transducers, some applications like hearing aid, ECG, EEG, electronic nose, electronic tongues, various microcontrollers. Then I will end up with, say, IoT in healthcare, now emerging fields. And lastly, I would conclude with the conclusion of the microcontrollers. So the background starts from in the history of, say, 1960s. So like in the last half a century, there was a replacement of analog signals by the digital signals. And it was in the year 1960s that the discipline of digital signal processing began to form. Two very important advantages of these digital signals were, it is easily to reproduce exactly what we are giving it in analog, and these digital signals can be manipulated easily. So today's digital signal processing is a major branch of technology in which we are working, and in electronics, basically digital signals are of very much importance. So what is actually a biomedical instrumentation is? Now, it is actually the application of knowledge and technologies to solve problems related to living biological systems, right? So what we are trying to do is we are trying to convert the biological, biomedical data of a human being like ECG, EMG, or say temperature, blood pressure, everything, and that is to be converted into digital form. So that is being done by this field or emerging field of biomedical instrumentation. Diagnose or treat or prevent the diseases in humans. So this is what is the emerging field in electronics. Now, what is the need of instrumentation in the medical field? As we are know that we are having accidents and then we require first aids. Then we use it for the BP measurements, ECG, heart attacks, and brains, that is EEG, and other things which are required by the human beings for their daily routines to their daily routines to explore them. So these were the things. Then what is actually the biomedical instrumentation is? Now, we have a small little block diagram, which everybody might be knowing over here. So this is the analog filter that we are having. This is the analog input, which is supposed to be given to the analog filter. And this is going to be a transducer or a sensor or anything which is going to convert this signal into an electrical parameter. And this electrical parameter is then is going to be converted into analog to digital signals. And now this digital signal is being processed by microcontrollers, and then they are again being converted into analog, and they are used for the diagnosis purpose. Means we can have a printout, we can keep the data, and we can record the things, and we can use it for further also. So nowadays, without this digital signal processing, it would not be easy to analyze and visualize data and perform their design and so on. As far as electronic students and electronics researchers are concerned, we require some history of the things, history of biological data, which is to be manipulated and which is to be used for the further development of new bio instruments, which were used in biomedical healthcare industries. Now, these DSPs is very often used method in biomedical researchers. And also, we know some of those instruments like ECG, EMG, EEG, and say X-ray machines, ventilators also. So we are going to explore all those in the coming slides. So these are some of the basic needs of biomedical instrumentations. Now, a basic biomedical instrumentations without a microcontroller would be like this. If you are able to see my screen, I hope I am visible. Hello.
Yes, you are visible.
Thank you, sir. Please keep me updating if I'm not checking it.
All right.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. So this is a basic instrumentation system which would look like without a microcontroller, sir. So if you are able to see, these are some of the energy sources which might be electric, light, infrared, mechanical, ultrasound, and these parameters are being converted through this human body, and which are detected by the sensors, the transducers, the electrodes, and then they are given to some of the amplifiers, and then they are being processed, they are being amplified, or they are being used to record the analog signals. And the whole thing was controlled by these control systems, and now they are being used to alarm, to display the data, to store the data, and to transmit the data, as well as to record the data. So these were the main roles of the basic instrumentation system. Now, if you are implementing some microcontrollers in it, then how it might look? So basically, again, the same data are being taken from a human body. They are being taken by lead, they are taken by the transducers, sensors, and they are given to a multi-channel AD converters, and these multi-channel AD converters, the output of which are given to microcontrollers, and they are being interfaced. They are being interfaced through RF waves, and these RF waves can be used by Bluetooth, Zigbee, wide local area network, or Wi-Fi nowadays, and they can also be connected to mobile phones, laptops, PDAs, and now as we are talking about Internet of Things, they can be stored on the server, and which can be used to detect and diagnose all those things. So these are some of the important parameters of microcontrollers which we are recently developing in the present electronic world. So this is the basic biomedical instrumentation will look like, and then these are some of the sensors and transducers which I need to show all the students and researchers, which are available in the market and which can be used very easily. These are some color sensors, these are some gas sensors, we have LDR sensor, thermistors, proximity sensors, ultrasonic sensors, IR receivers, PIR sensors, range sensors, and so forth and so on. And these sensors can be used. Even we are having some modules of those. These are some basic sensors which are being used by the electronics fraternity for the development of instruments. And now we are working on the basic biomedical instrumentation instrumentation, then we are using this sensors. Now, what type of sensors we are going to use for, say, the biomedical field? So we have some small sensors, like this is a pulse generator sensor. Day after yesterday itself, I went to the market and I have seen this as very small pulse sensor, which has itself inbuilt microcontroller, everything in it. And if you see at the size of this, say the size of this is a very small, you can put it on your finger also. So this is a small sensor which is used for the heart rate and the pulse sensor. So this is actually used in the Arduino kit, which we also been exploring during this talk. So this is a small sensor that can be used, and these programs and softwares are already being available on the open source sources. So these are some of the small sensors that can be used for biomedical instrumentations. Then which type of biosensors we are using? These are some of the biosensors, as earlier I have showed you, the heart sensor and a pulse sensor. Similarly, this is a small sensor in which we can have these five basic components, which is having a sensing element, which can be which can have a transducer, a single signal conditioner that is amplifier also, and then a data processor that is a microcontroller, and then the output generator. So the whole thing can be implemented in a very small sort of package, which is readily available in the market, and which can be used for n number of purposes, n number of n number of applications in biomedical instrumentations. So these are called as some biosensors. These biosensors are readily available and we can use it. So my appeal to all the research fraternity that we can explore many things, and we are still lagging behind in developing these types of instruments. We are exporting these instruments, sensors from foreign countries. Why our Indian peoples are not able to develop or say prepare these types of sensors here itself in India? So coming to our talk, applications of microcontrollers in biomedical instrumentation, we will be exploring some of the applications of these, like hearing aid, ECG, electronic nose, electronic tongue, ventilators, so and so forth. Some of those examples which would hopefully ignite the new generations to deal with this biomedical instrumentation in microcontrollers. So first of all, there is a hearing aid. Now, what is the basic concept of an hearing aid? If I call a hearing aid, this is a small electronic sound amplifier, nothing else. Sound amplifier which can amplify the sound. A person who is not able to hear a voice can use this small system, which I'm going to show you. Now, what it might have, a sensor or a voice mic, small mic, which can hear this sound, and then he is going to amplify that sound, and he can it can be given to a small speaker which can be put in our ears, which will be able for the person who is not able to hear small voices will be able to hear this voice. So this is that. And then this is a small unit that I'm able to show. Now, this is a hearing aid which was used earlier, which was made, in which we are having a very small microphone inside, and then we are having a small amplifier consisting of transistors and all, and then we are having a small battery over here, say a button cell. And then this mic will hear those sounds, and then it is going to amplify a little bit. Then it is going to a speaker. Now this speaker is, if you are able to see, now these speakers are being directly connected to the ear lobes, and therefore they are very easy for a person to hear. And this can be put in the ear itself, like we put say our goggles and all, so we can put this. This was the system which we were using earlier, in the earlier days when these microcontrollers were not in that form. So now they are being replaced by a digital hearing aid or a microcontroller based signal processor. Now these systems now are using microcontrollers for the processing of these data. Now they are used in variable sizes and variable shapes, and these are having a small microcontrollers processors based inside it, which will be doing all these jobs of amplifying those signals and recording these signals, and they can be given directly to these sorts of hearing speakers. Now the thing is, I was working under, I was fortunate to get a chance to work under our earlier speaker, the Professor Abhay Deshpande sir. And I came to know that we are having a very small size of microcontroller of a tape-like structure. And he is using those microcontrollers for variable applications. And he is a very tycoon in microcontrollers. So these microcontrollers are very small in size and can be used anywhere in this. So if you are able to see, these are very small sized nowadays microcontroller based hearing aids that are coming up. So what are the basic differences why we are going to employ microcontrollers inside this can be seen by these some of the advantages which digital hearing aid has. This generally cost less than digital hearing aids. So analog hearing aids are very cheaper, and these can be programmed with noise reduction algorithms to help reduce background noise, highly programmable for various listening environments, most flexible and adjustable for specific user needs. So these are some of the advantages of a digital or a microcontroller based hearing aids that are coming up nowadays. And there are some more advantages of analog hearing aids also, but we are mainly concerned about the microcontrollers which are being employed in these types of hearing aids. Now the second one we are working on, or we might be knowing, are the ECG or the electrocardiograph. So in this ECG, the potentials, the biopotentials of a human body are being taken by the electrodes, and they are being processed by these, and then these are given to the microcontrollers, and they are used for recording and for diagnostic purposes. So ECG is nothing but the electrocardiograph, that is the electropotentials or biopotentials of heart. So these are being taken by the electrodes which are connected over here, and by calibrations they are given to microcontrollers. So these are some of the basic applications where we are employing the microcontrollers nowadays. These are some of the ECG signal measurements devices which are being used. These are the desired input, interfering inputs like 60 to 50 hertz noise voltage, displacements, currents, and modifying inputs are orientation of patient cables when the plane of the cable is perpendicular to the magnetic field and the magnetic interference is maximal. So these are some of the devices where we can drastically use the microcontrollers in biomedical instrumentation. Now the second one is the electroencephalograph. That is actually nothing but the recording of the signals of human brains. So we are going to now detect the frequencies which are coming out of human brains, and we can use it for this. Though these signal parameters and patterns indicate the health of the brain, EEG is the key area of biomedical data analysis, and microcontrollers are playing a vital role in these electroencephalograms.
So how they are now and origins of brain waves. Now these are some of the waves which are being generated by the brains, which we termed as alpha, beta, gamma, delta and theta. And here are the mental conditions, the psychic conditions of a humans. And there we have discussed that how we can use these signals to detect the various, say, abnormalities in human body. So if you are able to see this, this is the situations of a human body. And as we have recently heard about Sushant Singh, he has committed suicide. And if we might have done his EEG and we have been controlled monitoring those things, so he might not be able to do that suicide, because it requires a certain level of, say, human abnormality, where we are not able to understand what is wrong and what is right. But a man wants to do something, and that might be in the form of a suicide also. So these are some of the parameters which are very important in biomedical instrumentations. Then we are having electronic nose. This is what I have, say, cropped from my, one of my eminent, guru, Professor Gaurish Naik from Goa, who is always keen to show these electronic nose. And this electronic nose can sense the smells of different things, which can be used very, very widely. The applications can be used for air, water, soil, plant, volatiles, and so over and so forth. So if you are able to see, these can be developed. And the cost of these devices are very high. In our, environment, in our India, why we are not able to develop these sorts of things? So this is something which is very innovative. So we can use this electronic nose. Then we are again having electronic tongue on that note. So electronic tongue, if you are able to see this, so this is a very small chip. Now a tongue senses the taste of a certain things. So that can be detected by using these sorts of sensors, and in which we can employ microcontrollers very widely. Microcontrollers can be used. And now expanding the field of microcontrollers, we can use the liquids dissolved in organics and inorganics, aquatic mold growth, soil analysis, and many things. Even in our human body also, we are able to have some chemical compositions due to which we are affected by some viruses or diseases likewise. So this can be done. So why not we can develop some of the biosensors which can detect the COVID virus itself when it enters from the mouth. So if you are having these sorts of electronic machines or electronic biosensors, I hope there might not be any COVID patients in here. So these are some of the most important things. Now, some more applications are like dialysis, in which we are having the impure blood, and we are purifying it, and then we are again transferring it. So these all employs greater hardware and software techniques to do these things. So these are some of the applications of dialysis, some of the applications of microcontrollers where we are using microcontrollers very drastically and very widely. And nowadays, due to this corona pandemic, we are very much in short of ventilators, where the patients who are very serious in COVID, and they require these types of ventilators. And as we know, the conditions of say US, there were no ventilators. The patients were outside. The COVID patients were outside. So these are some of the things where microcontrollers are being employed. Now, coming next to that, we have some wearable monitoring devices also. So if you are able to see, we are now using these sorts of wearable monitoring devices like this, which can check your steps and all, and we are using it all. Even the mobiles can be connected on your watches, on your wearable devices. So these are some of the basic things where we can explore ourselves, and we can have a tremendous research on those things. Even some of the so these are the parameters that can be developed. The day before we were talking about some of the parameters which can be inbuilt to the students, so that the device itself will measure the temperature of that students, and we don't have to measure those temperatures. So this can be done by this. Now coming to the microcontrollers, I'm talking about microcontrollers, applications of microcontrollers, and in biomedical instrumentations. I hope this might be Professor Abhay Deshpande sir would say scold me on this if I talk in microcontrollers, because he is a very a tycoon in this field. But I will little brush all about this microcontrollers. There are various microcontrollers like Arduino. These are the module kits which are already being available in the market and at a very low cost. And these are some of the ICs of microcontrollers which can be used, AVRs, ARMs, and ATMEL. So that can be programmed. And these are specifically Arduino peripherals, are very nice, very easy to use. And we have in the internet open sources of open sources of sites where we can download the programs, we can program the Arduino, and we can check some small little programs where we can use small parameters. The day before yesterday itself, I've seen at Deshpande sir's workshop, some students were working on biosensors, I say heart beat measurement and pulse sensor. They were working on this Arduino, and they are very simple gadgets which we can develop. Now, if the programs which are able to run on this microcontroller can be can be induced in a very small microcontroller chip, and that can be used for those sensors and all. So this is the Arduino peripherals which are recently widely used. Then would like to talk on this, that we are having some simulations also, Tinkercad Arduino simulator, where we can have n number of programs simulation devices, small resistances, capacitors, and all module sensors, where we can use those sensors, we can use those programs, and we can check those programs there itself in Tinkercad, and then they can be copied and they can be used for your applications also. So this is a very nice platform, Tinkercad simulation, which is a very widely used, and it is free of cost, of course. So we can use it. So this is a Tinkercad. Then these are some of the applications which I need to show you, that where Tinkercad is having, we can have some small motors rotating, we can develop some robots, we can have IR sensors, ultrasonic sensors, and then we can develop some, we can store, or we can see it on the LCD displays and all. So these all softwares are readily available on Arduino platform, on also on Tinkercad. So we can use these programs already installed, and they are very cheap in cost. Say I have brought this Arduino kit in around 300 rupees, and we can develop so many things on that. So this is Arduino. And the second one is a very important coming up, is the Raspberry Pi 3. Now, this is a dynamic sort of microprocessor, microcontroller kit, where it's just equivalent to Pentium PC. Now, it has got everything inbuilt inside it. It has got Wi-Fi module, it has got Bluetooth module, and it had got USB, it had got LAN, WAN, everything connected in the small module of Raspberry Pi. So it's a wonderful tool where we can explore many things. and hopefully sir might be talking on this. So what is actually a Raspberry? I will just brush it a little bit of introduction of Raspberry Pi. It is actually a credit card size single board CPU which was developed by UK by Raspberry Pi Foundation in 2009. And this concept initiated by Aidan Upton, who works at Broadcom, to promote the study of basic computer science studies in schools and colleges to develop interest among the kids and adults. Mind this, friends, student friends, that this is for you people. Now they develop these kits for the students to learn these sorts of programming, a basic sort of programming where we can explore many things. So this is Raspberry Pi. Even these are some of the peripherals which I need to show you all, that they are having, how many peripherals they are having. I have just talked it. You can have a network LANMAN connector over here. You have four USB ports connected over here. You have a HDMI cable. Then you have a camera port, audio, video port. This is the microcontroller that is being used. This is USB power. And these are some display ports over there. This is a Bluetooth module. And again, we are having some Wi-Fi module also. So this is a very wonderful tool for exploring new programs for the students and the research fraternity. So these are some of the platforms where we can use this Raspberry Pi free of cost. So this is learning from program that is Python, C, Java, a little bit of extensions, Ruby, Perl. Python is a superb programming tool. These all works on this. Then we are coming to the next small portion. I will take it as the IoT, that is Internet of Things. This is a very emerging field in healthcare industries. So this is Internet of Things, means where we can use the data which is somewhere stored in the server, and that data can be used for the further diagnosis or the further use of that. So say, for example, if you are expecting a weather report, so what was the history that is being stored in these conditions, of these environmental conditions, this temperature, this pressure, and the moisture that we have in the air. So in this situation, what was the rainfall? What was the type of a season over there? And that can be used for this. And though the things, this all is called as Internet of Things. So now nowadays, Internet are very widely used, as you all know. If you are using YouTube, and if you are subscribing some channels, and if you are able to see some new YouTube channels. So what happens whenever you switch second time, you'll able to see the similar sort of videos are being displayed on your screen. Why is it so? Because they are keeping track of your interest. So as you are seeing those videos, they will already be pushing those videos on your screen, so that you might be requiring those. So these type of data can be used in healthcare also. So this is the whole thing is called as the Internet of Things. Now these Internet of Things can also be used for a biomedical instrumentation. Now how this can be used? Now can you imagine that how you are going to predict there is a chances of a second heart attack? So this data is to be somewhere in the database, in the server. And using this data, that the people who have this second heart attack, what were their symptoms at that point? What were their age? What was their diseases? What were their parameters? What were their condition of the heart? What was their condition of their pulse rate and the other parameters of a body? And using those data, we can predict that with what are the maximum probability or the maximum chances of having a second heart attack. So this is going to be our tremendous revolution in the field of biomedical instrumentation to use this. So this was one of that. And again, this is the IoT infrastructure that very say available, readily available on the readily available over the these pages. Free of cost, you can use those servers for those things. Amazon, Wind River, Intel, Cisco, Google, and they are providing this platform, and they are providing the data also for your use. So this can be used. Then these are some of the servers that those are very free of cost, and those can be used where we can use that data for our applications. So these are some of the servers. Now, coming to a little bit of a machine learning. Now, a simple thing, machine learning, and is called as artificial intelligence. Just thing I have showed you, I have talked about the Internet of Things. Now, this Internet of Things can be used to teach the machines, which we call it as the artificial intelligence. Now, if I want that a car should be driven without a driver, so what type of what type of parameters were required for required for an accident to come? So what speed should be there? What must be there? How we can turn to the left, turn to the right? So we have GPS system. We can monitor that, and these are all things can come under a machine learning. We can teach the robots, we can detect. Someday, I have heard about some doctors which were examining the COVID patients. And since there was a risk of getting themselves, with that COVID virus itself. So to make sure that they should be maintaining a specific distance from the COVID patient while examining this, can we develop some robots which can detect those things, those parameters, which can see whether they in the tongue or in the that there is some viruses or not. So if we can develop these sorts of things, and these are the things where we require these types of machine learning programs. And say the machines can be taught how to diagnose, how to treat, and we are maintaining the distance, we can do these things. And these are being done only using the microcontrollers of various sorts. So these are some of the machine learnings. And now, why machine learnings are used? So machine learning quickly and automatically produces models that can analyze bigger, more complex, and deliver faster, more accurate results, even on a very large scale. This is the application of machine learning. So machine learning also facilitates computers in building models from sample data, and in order to automate decision-making processes based on data inputs. So these are the basic requirements why we require machine learning. Now, what are the examples? So I was just discussing about some of the heart attacks. Now here I am given another example where we can have the detecting cancer in this. So to predict what are the symptoms for a patient in a cancer, say for a mouth cancer, or say for a breast cancer. So what are the symptoms? So these data can be used to teach the machines. And this is the real-time examples where we can use microcontrollers in hospitals. Then these are some of the applications, including the healthcare, digital marketing, spam detector, as you all know, that there might be some mails which we have and which doesn't have any relevance. So those mails are being directly put on the spam itself. So, and so many are there. So these are some of the things that I need to discuss. Now, coming back to the students, which I am very, very concerned about, of electronics, basically, BSc and MSc electronics students. And as we are all know that there is a falling age in the electronics engineering field. There are no students in the engineering field, and I hope. But on the contradictory, what I feel and what I know is that there are many, many job prospectors of MSc electronics students, and there are simple basic MSc electronics are required over there in these the tycoon in this, and they are as I heard that he is a member of Texas Instrument, as you are able to see over here. So there is lot more requirement of instrumentation peoples in over there. And they also we were talking about there were so many requirements of basic MSc electronic students in Vietnam itself. Though China has since Japan has shifted some of their industries in say Vietnam and some other countries. So there was a drastic increase in the requirements of these peoples, basically electronics peoples, who can understand the hardware as well as software also. So my main job as a teacher is not only to teach a student, but also to provide some of the platforms where they can excel themselves and they can explore their careers also while enjoying this electronics field. So these are some of the fields which I need to show you in this talk. And lastly, I can conclude that the microcontrollers in biomedical instrumentation is very, very high. And we should work on those biomedical instrumentations. We should learn those biomedical microcontrollers, and we can explore them in n number of fields, not only in biomedical instrumentations, but there are various problems where we can discuss, where we can solve those problems by using microcontrollers. Now, coming to the field, we can conclude that by using this biomedical microcontrollers, we can give doctors a hand for treatment as well as for diagnosis. So we can check all those things. Results now, the results of the microcontrollers are very, they are very near to accurate. So we can predict many things before the calamities to happen. Again, the efficiency of these instruments using microcontrollers are very high. Then in this pandemic COVID-19, it is very useful that those microcontrollers can be used for n number of applications, specifically on biomedical front. So I request, it's my personal urge from the bottom of my heart, that all the students should take a very, very important note that the biomedical or the instrumentation or the electronics is never going to die. And there are lot many scopes. Just we have to explore those scopes. And without fearing about the jobs and all. So you can develop your own, as Professor Sharma sir has rightly said, that our Prime Minister has said that we should have an Atmanirbhar sort of India. So we can develop those instruments here itself in India. We won't have to export those instruments from the outside. And we can develop these biosensors. We can develop n number of applications of microcontrollers, and we can explore our careers in those things. And even there are a lot more requirements in abroad. There are biomedical universities. I have heard about many biomedical universities abroad. One of our colleague who was the speaker in our international web symposium, Biomedical Instrumentation, a Boon to Healthcare Industry, Professor Ali Reza, he was from Toronto, Canada, and he was dealing in robotics. So he required a lot of hands in robotics in biomedical instrumentation itself. So it's my personal urge for all the instrumentation, all the electronic students, that they should take maximum benefit out of the course which we have designed for you people. And this is all from my side. So this is what I need to tell all the students. Success doesn't but in effort. So keep learning. And in this COVID-19, you had made it a point to listen to me patiently. And I am very thankful and obliged to Professor Pawar sir, who has given me this opportunity to present my thoughts and views of microcontrollers in the application of biomedical instrumentation. And thank you very much. Thank you, sir, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you all, the principal of Dr. Ambedkar College, madam, and Sharma sir, and all the members of this organizing committee. Thank you, one and all. Thank you very much, sir.
Well done, Nilesh. Very nice presentation. Good. Keep it up. We expect many more things from you.
Okay. All right, Nilesh.
Thank you. Keep sir. Coming to the department. Now, you find that of things.
Okay. Thank you very much, Nilesh. Sharing valuable knowledge with us. Now there are so many things you have to explain, like a biological. There are many biological sensors, element, hearing of aids, ECG, and sound of a amplifiers. That small sound of amplifiers that can be converted electrical signals into the sound signals, and the so many applications on the basis of a microcontroller. You have already explained, and we are very much thankful to guide us about the applications of a microcontroller. Thank you very much, Nilesh. There are some questions. Please
I will try to.
And I hope that good morning, Nilesh sir.
Good morning.
It was
ma'am.
Very informative session.
Thank you.
Participant want to know, Sakshi Kimatkar. She want to know what is the difference between Arduino and microcontroller.
Okay. Sakshi Kimatkar is all actually she is my student of Mohta Science College. She is in semester 6. Very nice question, Sakshi. Actually, microcontroller is basically a chip, and Arduino is a full module where we can program the circuits. So microcontroller is basically a small chip we can program. I hope Abhay Deshpande sir is there, and I have not overruled him. I won't cross his arena of microcontroller. So he will talk more about microcontroller as such, and he will also explain about Arduino.
Okay, thank you, sir. So I want to know, what is the future of the microcontroller? Can it become nanocontroller in future? Nanomaterial, yes. It can be.
Yes, of course. As we can see you that we have a microcontroller on our fingertip.
Yeah.
So if we are inducing or if you are integrating a small thing in a very small package, so we can have a nano sort of things also. We are having many more biosensors and bio devices which are being used in the biomedical arena, right? So this can be
chalu rahu deta.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.